Hello, Dr. Urban here with a book review about the book End of Alzheimer's, the first program to prevent and reverse cognitive decline by Dale Bredesen, MD. The End of Alzheimer's sounds beautiful, promising, hopeful, and much more. It truly is. Who should read this book? This is a 300-page book. Certainly, medical providers and academics across a broad spectrum of discipline should read this book in order to formulate comprehensive, customized treatment plans for Alzheimer's patients. If you are in cognitive decline, I would not recommend reading this book alone. It is not a light read. You might become frustrated if you can't follow the science, the ramifications, the treatment suggestions, etc. Have a friend or caregiver read the book with you. The book puts forth Dr. Bredesen's ReCODE Protocol. ReCODE stands for Reverse Cognitive Decline. I will not get into the ReCODE Protocol details in this video. They're too extensive. Importantly, in Appendix B in the book, page 285, Dr. Bredesen gives the basis for the ReCODE Protocol with an explanation of the proofs. Also on page 285. This is for the scientists who want scientific backing. Also, there are over 200 peer-reviewed publications supporting the ReCODE protocol, according to Dr. Bredesen. The End of Alzheimer's is a tipping point in Alzheimer's understanding and treatment. Providers can no longer say, we can't do anything about Alzheimer's. You got it? Central to the book is the difference between monotherapeutic and programmatic approaches to disease. Alzheimer's disease does not have one causative trigger. There are many causes, and therefore you need the programmatic approach. Dr. Bredesen establishes the point that we cannot end reverse Alzheimer's disease unless we identify and remove the triggers, probably several, causing the brains to defend themselves by producing the protective but nasty beta amyloid response. That's on page 27. Once these triggers or factors are identified, then the destroyed brain synapses need to be rebuilt or repaired. There are three subcategories of threats or triggers causing Alzheimer's disease. Number one is inflammatory or inflammation. Number two is shortage of supporting compounds such as hormones and minerals. And the third is toxic insults. Many of you know that I am an enthusiast of Dr. Stephen Gundry's program and book, The Plant Paradox. It was a dialogue between Drs. Gundry and Bredesen that led me to buy The End of Alzheimer's. Dr. Gundry's The Plant Paradox diet is wholly compatible with The End of Alzheimer's, in my opinion. After you read The End of Alzheimer's, where do you start? I will be making suggestions and steps to reversing Alzheimer's disease in future videos. Get Dr. Gundry's book, The Plant Paradox, as a first action step. Start by fixing your gut first. I will convey other information to you through video playlists, updates, other videos, and alterations and additions, which I might put in the description below this and other videos. Be sure to subscribe to this channel for more information about Alzheimer's reversal and repair. Be well, Dr. Urban. Do not make changes to your medical regimen without first consulting your medical providers. Seek out providers experienced in treating cognitive decline issues and who believe Alzheimer's disease can be reversed. It can. Just so you know, I hold Drs. Gundry and Bredesen in the highest regard. I am not their spokesman or a spokesman for either, just a grateful sojourner wanting to learn more. Join me in our pursuits.